What's up, guys? Welcome back to another beginner Japanese lesson from some guy. Got another set of problems for you today, but before we begin, as always, please be sure to hit that like button, subscribe, click that notification bell, so you'll know when new videos are released. All right, so we'll get started here with our kanji-based problem. So number 138, we have to choose the correct hiragana for the highlighted words in the sentence here. So how do we read these kanji characters? Pause the video, choose an answer, and we'll check. All right, so the answer is... 1番 です. 近い and 多い. So the sentence says, あのスーパーは近いし安いし品物が多い. So super means like supermarket is 近い, close, 安い, cheap, and 品物が多い. So 品物 means like products, the things you can buy. There are many 多い. So reading the sentence, you might be a little confused. Maybe this is your first time to see this shi. 近いし、安いし、品物が多い. I remember when I first read this sentence that it was confusing to me. You can say 近くて安くて品物が多い. So that's the exact same meaning. I don't know what the difference between using like the kute and the shi is. Maybe there's some slight difference, but technically, you know, the meaning is the same. 近くて安くて品物が多い. 近いし安いし品物が多い. So the meaning is the same. So it's just your preference. If you're more comfortable using kute, go ahead and use that. But just know that this shi serves the same purpose. You just add it at the end of the e, right? 近いし安いし. So it might be a little easier. But now we'll take a look at some of the characters that we saw. Like in the character for close, we had 近い. So we have words like 近所, which means neighborhood, right? So like a close place, right? This is where you live. Next, 最近. This is definitely a word you'll want to remember because you'll hear it a lot and you can use it a lot, you know, recently. You know, 最近日本語を勉強してますか? So have you been studying Japanese these days? Have you been studying Japanese recently? 近い, just as an E adjective by itself, extremely useful. You know, close or something is nearby. スーパーは近いです。映画館は近くはない. The 映画館, the movie theater is not nearby, but the super is close, whatever. And let's see, don't confuse close, like in English, you know, you might say like you almost got something, you almost hit something. So you might say, oh, close, close one. But in Japanese, this is 惜しい, ah, 惜しい. I remember I would play darts with my friends, you know, and we'd say this all the time. You missed the bullseye just by a little bit, ah, 惜しい. You know, almost, close. Anyway, moving on, we also had 多い, which is the E adjective for a lot or a great number. So we can say, for example, 今日お客さんは? 多いですね. So there are many customers. お客さんは多い. Or we can say 日本に美しい都市が多い. So in Japan, 美しい, beautiful 都市, beautiful towns が多い. There are many beautiful towns in Japan. So definitely some vocabulary words you want to know. 多い and 近い, useful for everyday Japanese. All right, moving on. Now we'll take a look at our vocabulary. So again, fill in the blank. So it says 鳥がたくさん空を 飛んでいます、走っています、遊んでいます、散歩しています。So pause the video here, choose an answer, and we'll check. All right, so the answer is 1番 です。飛んで、鳥がたくさん空を飛んでいます。 So of course, 鳥 means bird, たくさん, many birds, 空 means the sky, を 飛んでいます, are flying in the sky. So many birds are flying through the sky, many birds are flying in the sky. So we'll take a closer look now at these vocabulary words, because just like 近い and 多い, they're very useful for, you know, everyday Japanese. So first we have 飛ぶ, which has kind of a confusing meaning in English. It can mean to jump or it can mean to fly. So technically, you know, the bird is, you can say 飛んでいる, you know, it's jumping. And just like a rabbit might 飛ぶ, a rabbit might 飛ぶ as well, but the rabbit's not flying, it's jumping. And here we have, you know, 飼える, 飼えるが飛んだ. So 飼える means the frog. So, you know, you say the bird is flying, but you say the frog is jumping. Unless the frog really is flying. I don't know. Next, here we have just the sentence that we just looked at. 鳥が空を飛んでいる. But I really want you guys to pay attention to this, the particle that we're using here. 我. So we have the place, 空. And we don't say ni or de. We use 我空を飛んでいる. You know, flying through the sky. So just be careful, you know, it's easy to confuse, you know, because in English we might say ni, so you might think it's in or whatever. Or in English we might say in, so you might think it's ni, but it's wo. Next, hashiru definitely a verb you want to know, means to run. So we can say, kaze no yoni hashiru, to run like the wind, right? Or, you know, to keep it very simple, we can say, you know, sono otoko no hito wa hashitte imasu, that boy over there is running, right? Just running. Next, asobu means quite a few things in Japanese, means to play, but it also means to just visit or hang out. You know, like if you ask your Japanese friend, you know, 先週末 nani o shimashita ka? What did you do last weekend? They might say, oh, tomodachi to asondeta, which means like I was playing with my friends. But of course, you know, a 30-year-old man or woman doesn't play, right? So it means to visit or just to hang out with and have fun. So, you know, if a Japanese person tells you they like to play with their friends on the weekend, you know, they mean just hang out. So here we have a sentence that says, for example, いつでも遊びに来てください. So here we have someone inviting someone to their house to, not to play, not to asobu, but to visit, right? 遊びに来てください. Please come and visit. And finally, we have 散歩, which means to take a walk. So we can add suru to make it a verb. 散歩する means to go for a walk. So we can say 公園を 散歩する. So again, here we have the particle wo and our place. So we don't say we come, you know, 公園に or 公園で. We say 公園を散歩する, to take a walk through the park. So again, you know, 飛ぶ, 走る, 遊ぶ, 散歩, 散歩する. These are verbs you'll definitely want to keep in mind and remember. But no more vocabulary. Now we're going to look at our grammar for today's lesson. So number 140, again, we have to fill in the blank. So it says, これは 日本人だけ, 日本人ばかり, 日本人でも, 日本人ぐらい読めない漢字です. So how do we complete the sentence here? Pause the video, choose an answer, and we'll check. All right, so the answer is 3番です. でも, これは日本人でも読めない漢字です. So this is a kanji character that even Japanese people themselves cannot read. You know, not all Japanese people can read every single character. In fact, they have tests, you know, to see like how many Japanese characters or, you know, kanji can you read. So, you know, some characters, you know, even Japanese people can't read. So we can use this demo, 日本人でも, even Japanese people cannot read these this character. So we're going to take a look now. We just have our vowel, or I'm sorry, our noun. In this case, it was 日本人. So これは日本人でも読めない漢字です. So 日本人 is our noun. And we just add demo, so even Japanese people. And another example, we can say, それは子供でもできる問題です. So that is a problem, 問題, that 子供でもできる, even children can do. So 子供 is child, 子供でも, like even a child or even children can do this problem. And one more here, a slightly different meaning. So we can say, for example, maybe I'm talking with my friend and I'll say, hey, you know, お茶でも飲みましょう. So in this case, I'm not saying, you know, even tea, let's drink. I'm saying, you know, like tea or something. So let's drink tea or something. You're giving a suggestion. So it has, you know, this meaning as well. You know, お茶でも飲みましょう, like whatever, tea, coffee, beer, I don't care. Just お茶でも, tea or something, right? So that's a very, you know, casual way of speaking. So you'll definitely want to remember that as well. But that's going to do it for today. As always, you know, thank you guys very much for liking, watching, subscribing. And I really appreciate you guys telling a friend. Helps, you know, the channel grow. And, you know, if you know anybody who wants to learn Japanese, you know, have them take a look at my book. You can find a link for that in the description. It's on Amazon. If you do check it out, be sure to leave a review. That helps a lot. But that's going to do it for today. So we'll see you guys back here next week for another beginner Japanese lesson. Mata ne!